Welcome to the LCBO's virtual tasting. Today we're pairing up five Ontario craft ciders with five delicious Ontario artisanal cheeses. My name is Tara Luxmore and I'm a certified Cicerone, which is like a wine sommelier but for beer. I'm also a beer and cider judge and I have a certificate in cider and pairing making from Brock. Together with my real life sister, we run a company called Beer Sisters where we're both award-winning journalists. And today I'm here with Chef Jesse Vallins.
Hi, I'm Jesse Vallins. I'm the executive chef at Maple Leaf Tavern here in Toronto and our sister restaurant in Pickering Port. I also work part-time at George Brown College with cheese education. I'm an advanced Cicerone, certified beer and mead judge with the BJCP, and a certified sommelier.
So today we're going to pair up five Ontario craft ciders with five cheeses. But before we get down to the tasting, we really wanted to give you a little bit of cider and cheese 101. So let's kick it off with the cider. Today in Ontario, we have over 110 different cider brands and cideries. 10 years ago, we had
nearly as much.
A handful. Yeah. So the cider industry is really growing in our province. And one of the reasons that's happening is because we are the biggest apple growing region in Canada. So we have huge orchards all around the Great Lakes where they have this microclimate of cool temperate weather that makes it perfect for growing apples. And there's over 700 growers here in Ontario. And cider by definition is more like a wine than a beer. Sometimes it gets categorized more like a beer, but it's really like a fruit beverage. So it's fermented apple juice, and sometimes cider makers will add in different fruits, different spices, different culinary ingredients. And all the cider we're tasting today is made with apples grown here in Ontario.
Yep. Likewise, our cheeses are all made here in Ontario today. And, you know, cheese is one of the more ancient foods that we still eat today. It was, you know, originally made as a portable source of protein and just, you know, became an everyday food. We may not think of cheese being similar to a fermented alcoholic beverage, but it is a fermented product that starts out as milk and comes out completely different, just like cider starts out as apples and comes out completely different. I think there's never been a better time to enjoy cheese in Ontario. We have dozens of dairies producing hundreds of different cheese with different milks and different styles. There's lots of creativity and great quality going on. So yeah, I'm really excited for this combination.
Yeah, and this is all in celebration of the LCBO's Pair It Forward initiative, where we are drinking and eating local products made here in Ontario. So if you want to get more inspiration around that, you can check out the lcbo.com. And also, if you're a vegan and you don't eat cheese, there's one great Ontario-made cashew cheese that I would recommend. It's called Nuts for Cheese. It's made with organic cashews, and it was founded by a vegan chef who really misses cheese. So she started to make, like, I love their brie, and they have a whole bunch of different flavored ones. It's delicious. Okay, so let's crack our first cider. So we're starting with the driest cider, West Avenue Heritage Dry. And it is made just outside of Hamilton on an all-organic orchard that was planted about 5 years ago by Chris and his wife, Amy. And they are really passionate about cider making and really wanted to, like, bring some drier, really, like, expressive and complex ciders to market. West Avenue has won a bunch of awards. They kind of swept Glint Cap a couple years ago. That's North America's most prestigious cider competition.
Right on, cool.
It's kind of like the Oscars of the cider world, but there's a lot of plaid. But so they won a lot and they have a lot of respect and they're sort of paving the way for the different types of apples that we're using here in Ontario. So before we taste, I know we want to taste, it's exciting, but apples that are used to traditionally make cider are very different from the ones that we eat. Cider apples are like, they don't taste good if you, like, pick it off the tree and eat it, but it has, like, lots of tannins, which can make cider dry. It can make it a little bit bitter. And there's lots of different, like, complex flavors that can come out when you use them to make cider. So they're cultivating cider apples. They so far planted 6,000 trees, and they grow over 100 different varieties of apples. So you're really going to get some interesting stuff from them. So let's taste our cider. But before we drink it, I just wanted to go through the steps of how we taste cider. So the first thing we do is smell. Why do we smell first, Jesse?
Well, I mean, especially because this is a carbonated beverage, all of this, a lot of the volatile aroma is being pushed out right away that, you know, we're only going to get it this strong right now.
Yeah.
But, you know, as far as our olfactory senses can taste or sort of smell, perceive, you know, hundreds of different compounds, whereas we can only really taste five things. So it's really important to get aroma to know what we'll be tasting later.
Yeah, and if you're not smelling what you're eating or drinking, you're not truly tasting it. The next thing we always do is look. This is important for judging and for cider competitions, but also important to give you some visual clues of what to expect. So I'm seeing like a ton of bubbles dancing up the glass.
Yeah, and really fine bubbles too.
And it's like a really pale gold.
Mm-hmm.
It's quite beautiful.
It is nice.
And let's give it a taste. Just a little sip. So you kind of want to let it wash over your palate. You're looking for the balance between acidity, sweetness. It's pretty and dryness.
Yep, this is pretty dry.
It's pretty dry, yeah.
I like it.
And it's quite sour. And the bubbles are really, really fine. Like, yeah. They remind me of champagne. They're really nice.
Yeah, they are quite nice.
And then we do this other thing called chew, which sounds really weird, but it's a kind of good technique to deepen your experience. So Jesse's chewing right now. So you're going to make a chewing motion and also let some oxygen in your mouth.
Yep.
And it kind of like lets the cider like saturate your palate so you can taste it.
Yeah, you get it all
things.
Over your tongue so you can taste where it's being perceived everywhere.
Yeah, and then it also like with more oxygen, you're going to release more of those aromatic compounds.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm. So what are we pairing this up with?
Okay, so we're going to start with this cheese right here. This cheese is called Big Mama from a producer called Monforte Dairy in Stratford. It's a water buffalo cheese. I really like this dairy. I really like what they do. The matriarch of the company, Ruth Clausen, I think is one of the cooler people in Canadian food. I've known her a long time. She's a retired chef, got into cheese making, thinking it was going to be kind of easy, and ended up being one of the hardest things she ever did. Yeah. she's really creative. They do lots of great stuff. But what I really like about them is that she's very careful about who she sources from, making sure that the herds and the animals that they use are treated well and are allowed to go on their natural milk cycles. And the cheese is delicious, so there's nothing not to like.
Well, I have to say this is the prettiest cheese on the board.
Yeah, I think so.
And do I eat the rind?
You can eat the rind. So if we look at this rind, a lot of people would say this is a brie-style cheese. So brie is a place and not a style. What we have here is what we would call a bloomy rind cheese. That white around the outside is called a bloom. It's inoculated with something called Penicillium camberti. And that's what makes that sort of white mold what it is on the outside. Perfectly edible. You can try it. If you don't like it, just eat the inside. But I think it's part of the overall character of the cheese. On the inside, you can see that sort of grayish blue. That's a vegetable ash that is something just very historic used in preservation for cheese making. And adds a bit of flavor as well.
And it's beautiful. Okay, let's try it.
Okay. So if we were going to be tasting professionally, what we might do is take a piece of cheese and rub it into our palm or our fingers and then smell it like that. It's going to warm it. It's going to release aromatic compounds. The only problem with that is, say, if you're at a dinner party, then you've got cheese all over your hand. So you don't necessarily have to do that. But
I would honestly recommend doing it on, like, a first date.
Yeah, well, first date for sure, anytime. What you should do, though, I mean, smell your cheese. You know, see what you're picking up. Smell the rind. Smell the inside.
Smells really like lactic, like I think of cream.
Yeah, lactic, you know, the rind specifically has a little bit of mushroom going on. Not super complex, but still there's definitely something there. So let's give it a taste.
It is so rich and creamy. Mm. It's like sticking around on my palate. Mm-hmm. And you know what? The rind does have like a mushroomy flavor and earthiness, but it also like really complements how creamy the cheese is.
Definitely. So quite nice.
So it's pretty dense too.
It is. It's almost fudgy in texture.
Oh my gosh, that's a good way to describe it.
Yeah.
Fudgy.
So I think with this cider, it's going to be a great pairing because we've got those really fine champagne-like bubbles, and the little bit of fruitiness is going to be nice with the creaminess, and the bubbles is just going to scrub that fat off your tongue.
Yeah, and I always say that's like one secret weapon that cider offers that wine doesn't. So cider has all of these like beautiful, vivacious bubbles that scrub your palate clean, whereas wine doesn't. So the cheese kind of sticks around. So that's why cider is really great to pair with cheese. How's it tasting?
Oh, it's really nice.
Mm-hmm. It is really nice. Let's taste it together. I can still taste both.
Yep.
Like it doesn't clobber the other one.
No, you're right. Yeah, those bubbles really help.
And I find more of like the fruity flavors of this cider, like the peach, the elderflower, like the stone fruit come through a little bit more.
Yep, I agree.
Yeah, that's a great pairing.
For sure.
Yum. So, but I guess we have to do our next one.
Yeah, I guess.
So next up, we're going to try Spirit Tree Estate Cidery. And they make, their flagship is called Draft Cider. It used to be called Pub back when they opened many years ago. And you'll already notice that the color is a little bit different from the West Avenue Cider.
A little bit deeper.
A little bit deeper. And the carbonation looks a little bit different too. Before we taste, oh no, let's taste first. Then I'll tell you about Spirit Tree.
Okay.
So let's give it a smell. So there's like a lot more, I think.
A much more expressive aroma.
Complexity in the cider. Like there's like a little bit of like funkiness, and I say that a lot, but it's like kind of like earthy, like hay. I can definitely smell the apple, but it almost smells like red, like a red apple.
Red apple, but you get red apple skin.
And some.
I taste the core and the twigs.
Yeah.
And almost like you're tasting the whole apple tree.
And some like honey in there too.
Yeah, some honey, a little bit floral.
Smells really good. Okay, so let's sip it. Oh, you did already.
I'll do it again.
The carbonation isn't as fine, but I find the body is a little bit bigger than the West Ave.
It definitely
Even
is.
Even though it's lower in alcohol. This one is 6%, but it has a bigger body.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm getting lots of like sour, like tanginess in the after, in the finish.
Yeah, very much.
Yeah.
Like a fuzzy peach.
Yeah,
going on.
It's really nice. It's really good.
Very good.
And Spirit Tree has been around for 10 years. They celebrated their 10-year anniversary this year.
Mm-hmm.
Tom and Nicole used to run a family, like, pick-your-own fruit farm out in Caledon.
Oh, cool.
But they wanted to kind of change it up and do something different, and they love cider and they love bread, but they didn't know how to make it. So they did what any good, you know, aspiring bread and cider maker would do, is they went to France to learn the art of baking.
As you
then
do,
they
yep.
went to England to learn the art of English cider making, and Spirit Tree was born. And they have a huge orchard. They produce a lot of fruit. You can go and still do pick your own there, but they also cultivate a lot of different cider apples. And they make cider in the English style and then have tons of like pastries and bread and like wood, like beautiful wood-fired ovens. And it's like all like kind of nestled in the rolling hills of Caledon. So it is a really lovely bucolic place to visit.
Yeah, for sure.
Especially and you
right
can
now.
Get different kinds of cider there, including a really excellent non-alcoholic cider.
Cool. Sounds like a great road trip.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. So we're going to pair this with this cheese right here. It's Mountain Oak Gouda from New Hamburg, Ontario. So the term Gouda, or the name Gouda, comes from the town in Holland called Houda. It's spelled mm-hmm. the same way, pronounced differently. What Gouda is a what we call a washed curd cheese. Mm-hmm. So when the curds and whey separate, some of the whey is removed, which has a lower pH. It's more acidic. And water is added back in and essentially washes the curd and makes it taste sweeter. That's why when we have an aged Gouda like this, we get those flavors of toffee or caramel, sometimes raisin, going along with that really salty, umami savoriness that is mm-hmm. really great. Pairing it with this cider, because as you're saying, there's a lot more going on in the cider. It's a bit more intense, and this is an intense cheese. And what you want to consider when you're pairing anything at all, food and drink, is intensity first and foremost. Because if we had this cheese with our first cider, it may not be bad, but you'd probably lose some of that flavor in the cider because it is so intense. Having something that matches its intensity is going to, right off the bat, make for a better pairing.
Okay, so intensity match. Always look
yes,
for all, things to
all,
be
yeah.
equal.
First, okay. first intensity, and then you can go other places.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
Let's try it. I always love cheeses that have these, like, crystals in them, because they're, like, when you bite into it, it's, like, a little bite
yeah,
of,
little
like,
crunch.
Salty,
so,
like, umami.
These crystals are an amino acid called tyrosine that are actually a mood enhancer. And
really?
So that's why eating cheese makes you feel so good. Or what, one of the reasons, anyway.
That's really good to know.
Mm. So, you know, I smell
Sorry
this.
Sorry, I bit it.
Yeah, no, go ahead.
It smells kind of, like, nutty.
Yeah, there's some nut. I'd say hazelnut. And,
yeah.
you know, cooked milk and mm-hmm. and caramel, toffee. And just almost like a meat broth, like very savory.
Yeah, very savory. That's like my favorite kind of cheese, where you just feel this like deep sense of savoriness.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's pair it up.
Yeah, I think that's great.
That's really nice. Mm-hmm. I feel like that funky, earthy flavor we were talking about, they match each other.
Yep.
And then you get the sweetness of the cider kind of comes up a little bit. And I get deeper caramel flavors from the cheese.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, salt accentuates sweet. So, we just love sweet and salty things in general, salt, mm-hmm. caramel, French fries and ketchup, that sort of thing. So the fruitiness in the cider, just sort of comes out more with that salt in the cheese.
And how old is that cheese? How long has it
been aged?
I think
this is 3 years old.
Okay, wow. Okay. Yum.
Yeah, really delicious.
Great pairing. Okay, so next up, we're going to do something a little bit different. We're going to try a cider that has a different fruit added into it.
But we're going to try our cheese first.
Yep. We're going to try our cheese first.
So this cheese here, we have our Lindsay cloth-bound goat cheddar from Mariposa Dairy.
Yeah.
Cheddar is sort of what Ontario is known for. There's dozens of cheddars made in Ontario. This one is made with goat cheese. Cheddar, the name refers to the process of cheddaring the cheese curd. So when the curds and whey are separated, the curds are drained, then they're sliced and pressed on top of each other and, weighted down and then sliced again and pressed again. So if you look at a cheddar closely, you can see all those cut curds that are pressed together in the sort of a definition in between.
Is that why cheddar always tastes really dense?
It's one of the reasons, and also why it can be kind of crumbly as well.
Okay.
With those curds separating. So this cheddar is made, again, with goat cheese, and the cloth-bound process is another old preservation process where cheesecloth would be dipped in what historically would probably be some sort of animal fat or lard, mm-hmm. but these days it would be a more neutral oil, yeah. and then wrapped around the cheese so the fat, the oil, would prevent anything from coming in and protect against insects or, spoilage, but it would also allow that cheese to breathe and age properly.
Cool.
So one of the reasons why I want to taste this cheese before our cider is that it's quite high in acid, and I want us just to perceive how high in acid this cheese is.
Okay, I never think of it like that.
You may not think that, but it's going to be one of the reasons why this pairs with the cider so well.
It smells kind of sweet to me, like sweet milk.
There's some sweetness going on, some wet wool, beeswax. That's quite nice. But so when you're tasting, taste the back sides of your tongue, and that's where we perceive acidity.
Oh, yeah, it's a little bit racy for cheese acidity.
Mm-hmm. Almost mouth
watering. That's really cool. Yeah. I would have never thought of cheese as having acidity.
Yeah. And so going back to what we're saying about matching intensities, this cider that we're about to taste has a really high acid, pretty much at the same level. And that sort of match intensity is going to be our springboard into a really nice pairing.
Yeah, and I feel like I would have missed that acidity if I had the cider first because there's so much of it in there.
Yeah, probably.
It could have canceled it out. Okay, so now we're going to try Thornberry Cranberry Apple Cider. And it is made with Ontario apples and then Canadian-grown cranberries.
Beautiful color.
And the first thing you're going to notice is how beautiful the color is.
Yep.
And even the foam is pink, which I love. Yeah, I smell cranberries. It kind of reminds me a little bit of Christmas just because I associate cranberries with Christmas.
Thanksgiving.
But the apple is still shining through, a really nice, fresh apple.
Yeah, definitely. It is very bright, high acid. I mean, cranberries aren't really known for being sweet.
Yeah, so. It's really nice. Yep. I can taste the acidity at the back of my mouth.
Very much.
It's really nice. It's really fruity.
Yep. Very good.
And it doesn't, I don't perceive it as too sweet.
No, it's not. There is some sweetness there. And again, that's going to help, do another level of pairing with it, mm-hmm. with our salty cheese. But no, it's quite balanced.
Okay. Well, so let's try it together.
Yep.
One thing I do when I'm pairing up cheese and food with beer or cider is I take a sip of the cider, I take a taste of the cheese, and then
another sip after that.
Yeah. And then I take a bite of the cheese and drink the cider at the same time and see how they interact in my mouth. It sounds funny, but you can get a lot of different good flavor combinations and it can brighten a lot of flavors. I feel like the cheese is even more savory now.
Mm-hmm.
Next to this the fruitiness of the cider.
The very fruity cheese. And I'm actually tasting more defined cranberry and apple.
Yeah.
Now that we've got that salty cheese.
Yeah.
And I think, goat cheese and cranberry are a classic combination. I mean, we were preparing for this tasting, you know, I Googled goat cheese and cranberry, and you get more than 5.7 million hits come back on Google. So, and a lot of them are for recipes for a goat cheese cranberry log, you know, these things you would have at dinner parties. But classic combinations are classic for a reason, and they can help to make good pairings.
Yeah, and it's good to look to, like, classic food pairings for inspiration on what to pair when you're at home, because it's not, you know, it doesn't need to be really hard if you think about what you would normally, you know, have apples with, like pork and applesauce is a very classic pairing. So next time you're having some pork, you can crack a cider and you'll kind of marry those flavors together.
Definitely.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Very cool. So next up, we have this county cider pear. So it is an apple cider with pears. And it is from Prince Edward County, from County Cider. And you can't really talk about cider in Ontario without talking about county. So let's pour it and give it a taste. It's pretty pale and golden. And it has like a little bit of foam, lots of nice bubbles. And I'm getting like just tons of like candied pear, off the top.
Yeah. Little vanilla.
Yeah, vanilla. Maybe even like a bit of baking pear.
Yeah, for sure. Definitely a cooked pear flavor going on.
Yeah, let's taste it. Yeah, lots of pear, lots of apple. It's still, it's sweet. I can taste the sweetness in the finish.
Yeah, I'd say this is our sweetest cider so far.
Yeah. And it is our sweetest cider so far.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, and it has like a bigger body. Yep. So I think sometimes when we talk about body with drinks, like when I talk about body in beer or body in cider, it's really hard to wrap your head around. But I think about body as like on the milk spectrum. Yeah. So you think about like skim milk and you take a sip of it, it's like really kind of watery and light. And then if you have a sip of like heavy cream, it's really dense and viscous.
Yep. And you've got whole milk and half in between there. And
yeah,
you can go by that scale. It's a really good scale to think about.
Yeah.
For sure. So the cheese that we've got lined up for this one, this cheese right here, is Upper Canada Dairy Niagara Gold. This cheese is, or this dairy in general, I think is great because they source their milk from a herd of Guernsey cattle. So Guernsey is an old British breed of cow, really prized for its rich milk, really great in cheese making. Guernsey milk is higher in protein, higher in calcium, higher in vitamins A and D, colostrum, those sort of things that are really prized in cheese making, and they make for really great cheese. We see our sort of orange rind here. It's what's called a washed rind cheese. So that rind, in this case, is washed with a brine, but it could be washed with beer, wine, or some sort of alcohol. And that rind develops. And the washing brings forward sort of like a very pungent, funky aroma and a bit of bitterness to that rind. Some people can find it off-putting, but when you have the cheese all together, I think it's really great, and it's part of that cheese's character. That little bit of bitterness in the rind is quite salty as well. Having it with a sweeter cider like this actually makes for a really great pairing. That sweetness sort of tames that bitterness and saltiness.
Oh, that's really nice. Okay, let's try it.
Ladies first.
Sorry. Has a different texture than all the cheeses that we've tried so far.
Mm-hmm.
It's lighter. It's more airy.
Lighter, airy, same time creamy. That little bit of funk, that nice sort of mild bitterness that when you have it with the cider, it all just sort of melts together.
Yeah, it's a really nice match. I find I can still taste them both.
Mm-hmm.
And it kind of dampens the sweetness of the cider a bit, which is nice.
Yeah, but it's actually bringing more of that vanilla on the back end.
Yeah. And before we move on to the next cider, I just wanted to talk a little bit about County, because County Cider in Prince Edward County has been around for over 25 years. They're one of the oldest cideries in Ontario. And it really started when Grant Howe was taking over his family's orchard, like his apple growing business. And he decided that he really wanted to learn how to make cider. And so he did it. And 2 years later, he had his first cider in the LCBO. And so at a time when there's not very many cider makers, there wasn't a lot of places to learn. So people like Chris from West Avenue and Nick from Palmies would go to the County Cider. They'd hang out with Grant and his partner Jennifer, and they would learn how to make cider. And that's why he's very affectionately known as the grandfather of Ontario craft cider. Unfortunately, he passed, but his wife Jennifer and his family still make cider there, and they're all it's female owned and run, and they are still taking lots of visitors. They have lots of outdoor seating, and they have a lot of different ciders there.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, so on to our last one. And this is kind of like a hot trend in cider. Rosé, I know it hit the wine world a couple years ago, but cider makers are really looking for inspiration from the culinary world, from the wine world, from the beer world. And so they're making these beautiful, like pink-hued rosé ciders. One is made by adding Pinot Noir because it's made on a vineyard where they also make wine, Small Talk Vineyard. But other ciders, like rosé ciders, have like strawberries or blueberries added for color.
Yep, really nice pinks, like a salmon color.
I love it. Yeah. It's like...
It's very pretty.
Yeah, and I love to serve this in like wine glasses at like a girly brunch. And it's a lot less expensive than wine.
Yep, for sure.
So on the nose, yeah, it's pretty.
You can get that Pinot Noir influence. There's some unripe strawberry, raspberry, a little bit of pepper. But it's definitely
pepper?
Yep, a little bit of black pepper. They're definitely a apple cider. You get all that apple underneath.
Yeah.
Very cool.
It's sweeter.
Yeah, it's on the sweeter end of what we've had today.
Yeah, it is 6.5%. And the body is a little bit bigger than the West Ave.
Yep.
And the bubbles are looser, but it's still very carbonated.
Yeah, still very much. It's going to be nice to get that cheese off our tongue still. So
and I still get like strawberry in my mouth after I drink
definitely.
Which is nice.
Yep. The cheese that we're going to pair this with, our last for today, is Glengarry Celtic Blue. Glengarry is a great producer in Ontario. They're not this cheese specifically, but one of their cheeses called Lancaster in 2016 won the Grand World Cheese Award at the American Cheese Society Conference. A pretty big deal.
Yeah.
This blue cheese, and in no disrespect to the cheese at all, I'm saying, is a beginner's blue cheese.
Yeah.
Not in that it's not complex and delicious, but that for people who say, oh, you know, I don't really like blue cheese, this is a great cheese for them to try. Mm-hmm. They'll sort of go, oh, blue cheeses don't all taste terrible. Or, you know, what they think is terrible. This one, it does have that you know, really salty flavor, but it is really creamy. It's got some nice nuttiness, like sunflower. Just overall, I think it's a really great balanced cheese. That being said, it is salty. And having this sweet sort of berry-forward cider with it is going to sort of tame that salt, but also bring out some of the more fruity flavors in the cider as well.
Yeah, and when I was the person who said, I don't like blue cheese, it tastes like mold, the first, like, aha moment I had about, like, pairing up food with beer and cider was when I finally found a blue cheese I liked, and that's because it was paired with something that made the cheese taste a lot better. And so then I fell for blue cheese, and there's no going back. So we do encourage you to try it and pair it.
For sure. Okay.
Okay, let's taste this. And do I eat the rind, too?
Again, optional.
Taste it?
You can taste it. This one, I wouldn't eat the rind.
Okay.
Personally, but you can.
What smell?
See, it smells very savory. And you do get that sort of like toasted sunflower, a little bit of funk and barnyard.
Toasted sunflower, wow. And still, it's really lactic. I know I keep saying that, but it's like, it still smells like cream, like sweet. Mmm. It's so creamy and so salty.
Mm. Yeah, and that's really, that salt pushes those berry flavors right to the front.
Yeah, and like it dampens the funk.
Yep.
So you can really taste like how creamy and like umami the cheese is.
No, for sure.
And it makes the cider so fruity.
Yeah, really great combination.
Makes the cider almost sweeter.
Yep.
Yeah, that's really good. Wow. That was a good pairing.
Yeah, very much.
So that's it for us.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for watching our virtual tasting. Again, we want to remind you to please drink responsibly. You can get all the ciders and drink them on different nights, pour them into tasting glasses, and just enjoy them and practice smelling, sipping, and chewing. Also, we wanted to mention that the LCBO has same-day pickup available, so you can order everything online and go pick it up at your LCBO, and all these ciders are available on the website.
Yep, they are. All of these cheeses are made in Ontario. You can find them in cheese shops around the province, and, you know, I think it's great that we have such great products, cider, cheese, made here in Ontario. You know, I like to make the comparison that, you know, tourists didn't discover the great food in France or Europe. Like, you know, the French knew about it long before that happened. So I think, you know, we have a great opportunity right now to uplift our own product here and pair it forward, as they say.
Yeah, and if you want more inspiration on pairing Ontario-made products, go to the lcbo.com where there's a whole bunch of different wines and beers and local foods all paired up so you can celebrate Ontario. Cheers. Okay.